Hello students, hope you are doing fine. I'm Poonam Dua from Amend Education Academy of Literature, and today we are covering Unit 4 Non-Fictional Prose of UGC NET. The subtopic is Philip Sidney, An Apology for Poetry, or the other name, The Defense of Poesy, 1595. It was published in 1595 and was written somewhere around 1580. It is a work of literary criticism by Elizabethan poet Philip Sidney and was written approximately 1580 and first published in 1595 after the death of the poet. Let us get acquainted with Sir Philip Sidney now. He was born 30th November 1554 and died 1586, 17th October. He was an English poet. Not only a poet but courtier also, a courtier, scholar, soldier, and he is remembered as one of the most eminent, most prominent figures of Elizabethan age. One of his major works that we are going to discuss today is The Defense of Poesy, and there are few other prominent works also like Arcadia 1593, Estouffville in Stella 1591, and he is very much remembered today for the romance The Countess of Pembroke, Arcadia, the most recognized work of English prose fiction of 16th century. For Estouffville in Stella 1591, the first sonnet sequence in English, and for Defense of Poesy, the one we are going to cover today, Defense of Poesy 1595, which is in Arthur F. Kennedy's word, the first statement of English poetics, the first and still most important statement of English poetics. Arthur Kenny is a professor of literary history at the University of Massachusetts. An Apology for Poetry is a very important contribution to literary theory written in English during the Renaissance. And Sidney defenses or advocates a place for poetry in that kind of society, aristocratic state, we must say. His writing of the apology as a defense of poetry was occasioned by an attack on poetry entitled The School of Abuse, published in 1579. In his essay, Sidney integrates a number of classical and Italian percepts on fiction. Sidney sets up a parallel between soldiers, horsemen and horses in one realm of life and poets in another realm. Poetry, poets in his view, is the purest and highest form of writing, and he identifies the primacy in ancient Greece of poetry over science and philosophy. This particular essay opens with an introduction or exordium in which Sidney relates a conversation with a horseman named John Pietro Pagliano. John's passionate praise of horsemanship inspires Sidney to attempt a similar argument in support of poetry, imitating the style of ancient oratory or ancient worship. The author begs his audience to forgive any faults in his essay, any faults in his arguments in favor of poetry. Sidney calls poet haters misomosoi. It is important to remember and note this word misomosoi in his defense of poetry or poesy. Few poems which deserved qualified praise are Chaucer's Troilus and Crusade. Other poems singled out for praise are collection of moralistic poems, Mirrors of Magistrates, and Spencer's Shepherd's Calendar, which Spencer dedicated to Sidney, although Sidney criticizes Spencer for archaizing the language or using the old-fashioned language. According to Sidney, poetry is a moral power whereby poetry encourages the reader to evaluate virtuous models. The three kinds of poetry, according to Sidney, are religious, philosophical, and poetry as an imaginative treatment of life and nature. He calls special attention to third class of the poets in the promotion of virtue, good qualities. Both philosophy and history play their part, according to Sidney. Philosophy deals with its theoretical aspects and teaches virtue by precept. History teaches practical virtues by drawing concrete examples from past, from life. But poetry gives both perceptions and practical examples. So, in a nutshell, we can say poetry is full of virtue, breeding delightfulness, happiness, and it is not deprived of gift that ought to be in the noble name of learning. All the charges, all the accusations laid against the poetry are false and baseless. The poets were the ancient treasures of the divinity, and they were the first bringers of all civilization. There are many mysteries contained poetry, and a poet can immortalize people in his verses. Now I'm asking few questions from the same essay. What does Philip Sidney call poet haters in his defense of poesy? The answer is option D, misomosoi. The next one, in his defense of poesy, which of the following works does Sidney come in as good examples? The answer is option 3, first and second, The Mirror of Magistrates and The Shepherd's Calendar. Philip Sidney's apology for poetry is a defense of poetry against the charges brought against it by, the answer is Stephen Gosson. The next one, in the defense of poetry, what did Sidney attribute to poetry? You need to read all the four options and give the answer in comment. I hope you liked the video. Please subscribe to our channel to gain more knowledge about English literature and contact to join our face-to-face classes. Thanks a lot for watching. Best of luck for your exams.